All right, welcome to the Lion Lunch Hour. It is 11:34 on Monday, January 15th, Martin Luther King Day. Let's definitely honor him. I'm AYESHA Khan alongside Aaron Como. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. And joining us again, Antoinette and Grisella from Topolino's. Thank you, ladies, for coming in this morning from Camp Springs. We're going to talk about what is on the menu. And I just have to mention, Antoinette and I go way back. I'd say 3 years or so, right?
I love that.
Yeah, and she was so kind to let us into the restaurant. We were doing a story. It was nightside reporting. It was during pandemic. And we were looking for restaurants to talk to, right? They're still opening and how they're still accommodating. And Antoinette was so kind to let us because it was freezing outside. She's like, you want some hot soup? You want something to eat? And I was like, yes, please.
And
I'll take that. And
look at all this spread. This is amazing.
All right, well, listen, before we get sizzling, we have to talk a little bit about the weather, right? Because it was just snowy when I was coming in
this
morning.
Speaking of snow, right?
Exactly. Because, yeah, of course, our area is under winter weather advisory. We saw some snow and ice moving early this morning. And even though it wasn't a whole lot, it was enough to cause some traffic issues. Now, there is more on the way this afternoon and evening that could mean more issues for tomorrow's drive to work and to school. I am off tomorrow, so I don't have to worry about that.
Lucky
man,
you.
I do feel bad for the people who do have to go to school and to work.
I will be one of them in the mix.
I wish you all the best. Now, Tucker has been all over our winter weather coverage all morning long. Tucker, I know you've got to be tired, but I appreciate you hanging around for us to join us with more of on how much more snow we can get and what else the 7 day has in store for us.
Listen, let's be honest here. We have not seen snow in 2 years, so this is a big deal for us to even get a couple inches of snow. So far today, a coating to about a half inch of snow, but we got more on the way. Light snow being reported at this hour out of Dallas, 27 degrees. It's going to stay cold. That's a live look in Frederick, and the snow is coming down, and we got snow-covered streets and that kind of thing off to the north and west. So a bit of a break, but guess what? Snow's filling back in here, and as we get into the afternoon hours, not that it'll be a heavy snow, but it'll be a steady snow late this afternoon and tonight. It'll continue until after the midnight hour. I think by daybreak tomorrow, the snow should start to wind down, but we're looking at potentially a couple inches of snow. Yeah, look off to the south and west. There's more snow on the way. It will stay plenty cold. It'll be an all-snow event for us. And by tomorrow morning, I think parts of the area will be looking at, as mentioned, additional delays. We're looking at 1 to 3, in some cases, just off to the north, perhaps 2 to 4 inches of snow. It's been 2 years tomorrow since the last time we had an inch of snow in Washington. It looks like it happens later today. Plenty more on the forecast coming up. Food looks delicious, by the way, ladies. Back to you.
Well, we'll save some for you. Don't you worry, Target.
I think he's
earned it, right? He's definitely earned it. Just a reminder, we'll have complete weather coverage when the next round starts to fall on air and online, even during the basketball games later today. So you can tune in live using the free Fox Local app on your smart TV. All right. We got to get back to checking on what is sizzling now, and we're starting off with a story for anyone looking for love, because apparently dating apps are out and LinkedIn is in. Now, Business Insider report says that more people are using LinkedIn, the online business networking site, for dating. The report cites a Pew survey pointing to why both men and women feel disappointed using regular dating apps. Now, women often feel overwhelmed by too many dating apps messages, and men often feel like they don't get enough messages. Now, the report also went on to say people looking for dates prefer LinkedIn's platform because, you know, it's easier to avoid being duped by a fake profile or catfisher. Gosh. Now, date seekers are also trying out the platform because it adds a layer of credibility, something that many other social dating apps don't have much. All right. We want you to chew on that for a minute. Mixing business with pleasure, like it or not, you can vote on our website at fox5dc.com, or you can scan that QR code at the top of the screen. Ladies, what do you think of that? So, I was listening to you earlier, Aaron. I know you met your partner on the league. You and I talked about this.
We did.
I remember when you first connected with him, you were like, AYESHA, why aren't you on the league?
Yes, right? It's a great dating app.
I'm single. This time, I am single, so just putting it out there.
Go to LinkedIn right now and search CEO. business manager.
And stalk them and say, listen, are you single? See, I don't know. Is that kind of creepy line?
You don't want to be thirsty. That's the thing about
LinkedIn. No thirst trap.
But you know what? I really do think that you should give a matchmaker a try because you're a professional woman.
Right.
You're beautiful. You have a lot to offer. And you deserve someone playing on your level.
I appreciate that. Antoinette, are your thoughts on that? What's your take on that?
Like I said, after hearing from Autumn Joy, her perspective, it changed mine. I think that it's not a bad idea.
Uh-huh.
At least you know what you're getting as far as career-wise.
Now I'm going to have to check my DMs. I'm like, is this professional or is this guy hitting on
me? Exactly.
I mean,
do we even have a job?
But I will say, I do have a friend. She owns a business, and there are a lot of men who will be like, interested in working with her and want to have several coffee dates, and then she's like, wait, are you going to sign this contract or are you wasting my time and dating me? What's happening here?
Speaking of coffee dates, now, Erin, I don't know if you've been watching, you know, some of the TikToks and social media. A lot of women are saying, you taking me out to coffee, that means you are not invested in the coffee. I want dinner because coffee is like, I don't have to invest, right? I'm putting very little effort into this, but I'm like, you know what? What if you don't feel the guy? Or what if he doesn't feel you? And is the coffee like, all right, I'm done with the coffee, I'm out.
So. I would call coffee the pregame.
Pre-game, there it is.
Just
that's
the introduction, so you can at least meet the person, get a vibe, see if you like that person
or not. And you're not stuck with them if you're not feeling it.
Exactly, like, it is a short and sweet day. Short and sweet, get out of there.
Love that.
Exactly.
All right, well, moving forward, 30 and flirty, not the case for Gen Z. They are convinced life is over at 30. What are you talking about? Those born between 1997 and 2013 are expressing grim concerns about hitting the big 3-0. Some consider the milestone will take away their sexiness and their value. And many are getting baby Botox and covering themselves in face tape. Hashtags like anti-aging are trending on social media apps, but people of all ages agreed that the panic of getting older is getting out of hand. So, fearing aging, like it or not, ladies. Okay, so again, Erin, I was listening to you. I got frownies too.
Thank you. There's the face tape.
I put it on my forehead. I put it around my marionette lines.
Your smile.
My little smile lines. You know, because listen, Botox is expensive. All right. I have yet to try it. Maybe at some point I will, but like right now, I think
I'm
good.
You don't need it.
Well, thank you.
Amazing.
I appreciate it. I'm older than you.
You
I know you're turning 40. I'm turning 43.
Yeah. You are 43?
43 and fabulous.
I love it. So I thought, Antoinette, that I'd be nervous to turn 40 because it's such a milestone, but you know what? YOLO, life gets better.
Well, y'all look amazing.
Well, thank
Both
you.
And so do you.
Well, thank you.
And so does Graciela.
I'm not putting my age out there, but thank you.
You know what? That's okay, because I'd say that I'm going to be 35 forever.
I like that.
I like
that. You know, in my head, I'm starting at 25. For some reason, I'm stuck in 25.
Okay, I'm going back to 25.
I'll take that. But Antoinette,
I'm going to 21.
I'll take that too. I love when I walked in, you were like, you look beautiful, you look fabulous. I was like, do you want to just stick around and be great for my ego? Because I'll take that.
You know what's good for feeling young? Pizza. So we got a lot of work to do.
We do have some pizza. All right. Does Erin have any milestones coming up?
My 40th
in 2 weeks. Oh, my goodness. All right, happy early
but
birthday.
But if anyone asks, it's my 30th.
Okay, I love that. Well, podcast host Aaliyah Jarreau wants you to tell him everything. Coming up next, he's talking to us all about the show, the inspiration behind it, and much, much more. Stick around. We'll be right back.
advisories. And again, we're talking about potentially some pretty good snows around here. More coming up. Aaron, how are roads?
Well, unfortunately, you guys mentioned it. You know what happens when it snows around the DMV. Please allow for extra time. We're seeing green out there right now because we don't have a whole lot of traffic out and about. But please reduce those speeds. Leave plenty of room between vehicles. Take it slow. Watch out for those slick spots that can really sneak up on you. It might not look slick, but it could be with the flurries and snow in the mix. Also, just again, get up early this morning. Give yourself extra time to clean the snow off the top of your car because you don't want to be a hazard when you're driving. We got you covered in the next five.
All right, Aaron. Thank you. All right, here is a look at five things you need to know. The Martin Luther King Jr. Day Parade kicking off this morning in D.C. D.C. Mayor Muriel Bowser will be on hand for the annual celebration. The parade steps off at 11 this morning at the Rise Center and travels to Anacostia Park. Our Bob Barnard will be on the parade route with a preview starting at 6. The 2024 primary calendar kicks off today with the Iowa caucuses. Thousands of voters are expected to cast their ballots despite the severe wintry weather. Former President Trump remains in the Republican front runner, but new Iowa polls do show that Nikki Haley is ahead of Ron DeSantis. Now, it's been 100 days since the start of the Israel-Hamas war. To mark the occasion, there were protests across the world yesterday, and that includes right here in D.C. Thousands gathered for what they call the March on Washington for Gaza. The D.C. police chief said the demonstration was mostly peaceful. Congressional leaders have rolled out a two-step plan to avert a government shutdown. The deadline to pass the bill is this Friday. The legislation would fund some areas of the federal government through March 1st, the rest through March 8th. This would be the third funding stopgap bill since the funding initially expired back in September. And the Emmys are happening tonight. The hit TV show Succession leads the pack of nominees for Outstanding Drama Series with 27 nominations. Ted Lasso, one of my favorites, has 21 nominations, including Outstanding Comedy Series. The Emmys were supposed to take place back in September, but they were postponed due to the writers and actors strikes. You can catch the show tonight at 8 on Fox. A jury verdict may come down this week in a cold case murder of a Montgomery County Sheriff deputy. Larry Smith was charged with shooting and killing Captain James Tappan Hall. This happened in Rockville back in 1971. Now on the 50th anniversary, investigators went over the evidence and interviewed people named in the original files. They say Smith admitted to the murder and moved to Little Falls, New York more than 40 years ago. Residents in Prince William County have filed a second lawsuit over the impending construction of data centers. The lawsuit was filed against the Board of Supervisors on behalf of a dozen residents who live near the project site known as Manassas National Battlefield Park. The group says the land was rezoned without regard for impact on the region's unique historic, natural, and cultural resources. We're told it could be at least 6 months before there's any outcome or a decision.
The bottom line is we're here to fight for that legacy because it's a battle worth fighting for. And I'm so proud to have really good people around me.
A county spokesperson says officials cannot comment on any active litigation. Parents, listen up. Montgomery County Public Schools is launching a bus tracking app this semester. The app will give families live updates on where their students' bus is located. It will also provide a two-way communication capability. The school district's transportation department is currently in a pilot phase at 10 schools. American offices are the emptiest they have been in four decades. That's according to a recent report from Moody Analytics. It shows that nearly 20% of offices nationwide are completely vacant. The pre-pandemic office vacancy rate sat just below 17%. The three major cities with the highest vacancy rate are Houston, Dallas, and
Austin. Now, since the pandemic, the Arlington County Fair has seen a monumental growth in attendance, according to Arlington Now. The total number of attendees jumped from 65,000 in 2020 to 150,000 this past year. And while there are still months to go, plans are already well underway to help accommodate for the larger crowds.
So what they're trying to do is find ways to make sure everyone can get there while reducing impacts to the neighborhood that hosts the fair by adding more shuttles for parking off-site and perhaps more parking restrictions so that people aren't trying to, like, park on side streets in neighborhoods that really can't accommodate that level of parking.
All right, sounds like it's far away, but actually, you know what? Summer's not too far, and if you're looking forward to going to the Arlington County Fair, that will be running from August 14 through the 18. The Red Cross is teaming up with the NFL for the National Blood Donor Month. Anyone who donates blood this January will be entered in a lottery. They'll have the chance to win an all-paid-for trip to go to the Super Bowl. The Red Cross last week announced an emergency blood shortage. The organization reported its lowest rate of donors in 20 years. All right, well, it was a snowy start to the morning. And as we take a live look into the city of Fairfax, Virginia this morning, it is coming down and it actually looks really pretty, Tucker. I mean, not sticking to obviously the roads, but you can see it on the grassy sides there. And it seems like drivers are behaving.
Yeah, I mean, so far so good. The worst in some ways yet to come here is we'll have more snow late this afternoon and we'll get a couple inches by tomorrow morning. But just, you know, be cautious out there. Walking out on the sidewalks, everything's frozen. Look at the temperatures in the 20s. And with it snowing lightly, things will remain very slippery across the region later this afternoon. Secondary roads, that kind of thing. I don't think the crews will get to them until sometime tomorrow. So we'll continue to see the snow. It's filling back in here. And you can see with the radar, the white there, that's the snow flying. It's all snow. We're not getting a mix. You know, oftentimes we battle that rain-snow mix around here. Not today. More snow to come. There it is off to the south and west. I think the steadiest of the snow will be late this afternoon and tonight. Mostly out of here by 3, 4 o'clock in the morning when you're getting up tomorrow morning. Not that it'll be sunny, but the snow will be gone. I do think there'll be delays and that kind of thing as we've got a winter weather advisory for the region here. 1 to 3 inches of snow expected. All of the area shaded in purple. That includes us here in Washington and the immediate Washington area under that winter advisory later this afternoon. Doesn't get above freezing. That snow sticks around. Again, increasing snow later this afternoon. Let's take a look at the roadways. And Aaron Como's got the latest, right?
Yeah, that's right, Tucker. On-time traffic. And right now, we don't have a lot of volume on the roads. It is a snow day. Snowy mix out there, so a lot of folks staying home. So if you are out and about, just watch out for slick spots, the potential for those icy messes out on the roads. As we take a look, you can see we do have some closures along GW Parkway. Other than that, they're diverting traffic right now. We do have quiet conditions on the Beltway. But again, light volume out there. My advice to you, take it slow, especially on those secondary roads this morning, as Tucker mentioned. Crews might not get to them till later tonight or early tomorrow morning, and we'll keep you updated online and here on Fox 5 on the potential for more delays and closures as Fox 5 Morning continues. Aisha.
All right, Aaron, thank you. Coming up, combating food insecurity, the new federal program that could help millions of children in our region, and later, an urgent evacuation, a volcanic eruption sending one country into emergency mode again.